Hello, everyone. It's a great day. It's a great day because the Holy Spirit has been able to allow a prayer to be concretized here, come down to this level of concretization here, to help with these times that we're in. Very powerful prayer. It just came to me this morning. And that is, I abide with the light. Okay, that's the first part. I abide with the light. I abide with the light. Second part is, I live as the light. Okay, I live as the light. The third part is the kicker. The kicker of all kickers. Okay. I have no needs. I have no needs. So it's, I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. I have no needs. Now, this is so monumental that, as I have said, the ability to sit quietly is the most important ability there is by far. Nothing else comes close. It enables us to do business with truth, actually. So the fact is that those on the spiritual path are really business people. They're doing the real business of this world, the real business. They're not fooling around anymore. And in order to do business with truth, the capacity to sit very, very quietly, calmly, non-reactively, is all important, because in negotiations with the Holy Spirit, which who is the advocate, is the voice of light, the voice of truth, the voice of reason that can speak to us of the light, which we are, which is all that is. In these talks we have, business talks, the Holy Spirit will say, hey, let me offer you this. And we'll say, wow, what a deal. You know, we're making this deal. Let's exchange, you know, what our belief in definition and form and impermanency and all this. Let's exchange our belief, false beliefs, for this wonderful, amazing gift that the Holy Spirit has for us, gift of light. And the deal is so great in our favor that it is monumental. And it shakes us up. It shakes us up. This negotiation is very intense and very important. It's very full of stress for us. And then we get this, I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. And it's so powerful that you simply, it floors you. You have to just sit. Don't get into physicality. You might say it's the opposite of physicality, doing business with the Holy Spirit, the opposite of physicality. You're just letting the physicality be on the back burner, and you're shifting into the state of reason, and the state of realization, and the state of acceptance, and the state of evaluating what you're being offered. To hear, I have no needs, I have no needs, is the truth, is the truth. Light doesn't have any needs. We are the light, I am the light. There's only the light. Light cannot be separated from light. We believe that we've done so, or are in the process of doing so. We believe that there's this big, massive process that is going to result in light separating from light, but it's not true. It's not true. It only gives, light gives us the appearance that this is taking place, because we asked it to give us this experience. So we have this appearance as though There's this duality of light and non-light, a process of separation taking place. There isn't any process of separation taking place. That's an illusion. That's an appearance only. But it's actually all the one light. As they say, there's only one God, meaning there's only one light. The light is God. The living light is God. It's all. It's all there is. So we've had these appearances that light is separating, be it the two different lights, as it were, the light and the darkness. It's not, there's no separation. It's only this vast realm of appearances and contrast, vast realm of contrast of appearances, which we then take as differences. Oh, this is light and this is dark. Surely this is light, this is dark light. And this is, you know, really light, this is very condensed light, appearing as darkness, but it's still 100% light, the same light, the one light. But we're so used to the contrast that we think light has been separating, and so we're afraid to realize it's all just one light. No separation ever took place. We would like just be shocked by that. So we have to gradually do a soft landing into this realization. So the soft landing is called the vision of oneness, and we're aiming for that. So we say, I abide with the light. In other words, the light is here. I can see the light. I'm abiding with it, with this experience. I'm abiding with this formless light that is bathing everything perfectly. It's totally stable. I abide with the light. And then the next step is to say, functionally, I live as the light. I live as the light. I live as the light. This is a little stronger. It has to do with our functionality. I live as the light. I have no needs. Light is not needy. What does it need? It doesn't need any. It doesn't need. It is. It is what is. What is doesn't need any help to be what is. So it is not needy. I have no needs. That's a fact. This is a statement of liberation. This is a statement that's powerful enough to turn the tide during these times, to turn the tide. We have been set up in this world to fail, to continue to believe in the separation, to continue to believe we have needs. And so just to declare, to say, I have no needs is extremely powerful, extremely powerful. So monumental to say that I have no needs and to realize this is true. It's like, oh my God, are you kidding? I have no needs, actually. I don't have needs at all. That is true. Light doesn't need to breathe. Light doesn't need to eat. Light doesn't need to have a body. Light has no needs whatsoever. I am the light. Light has no needs. And you realize that this truth will become self-evident. It's on the verge of becoming self-evident. So certainly we're not going to give that up for the world's mantra of that we're super needy. In fact, we're more and more needy, totally needy. We're not going to give that up. So I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. I have no needs. Now, as you decide to accept this, that will have a profound effect on your life and functioning. Profound effect. Because you're letting the light then take care of everything in your life. You don't have any needs. You don't say, I need to take care of this. I don't have any needs. See, this is a statement of freedom. So I felt this prayer is the most powerful one I've ever come across. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. And then simply sit quietly. This is a prayer to sit quietly with and let it sink in. Now, the whole idea of the spiritual path is that we're making breakthroughs, great breakthroughs, which means we need to sit quietly in order to absorb the shock of these breakthroughs, the shock. The shock of realizing I am going to be functioning without any needs at all. That's coming up. It's a staggering realization. So it's necessary to be able to calmly accept these breakthroughs. That's the number one characteristic of the path, is the capacity to sit quietly. Maybe not talk at all. Or if you're sharing this, just talk quietly, gently. Repeat yourself. Not aiming for results necessarily, just allowing the shock of realization to set in, to settle down. It's like we just remove this massive block from our path off to the side, and the dust is settling. You look and you see there's nothing blocking you, and you've been blocked for forever, almost, it seems like forever, and suddenly there is no blockage there. You have to adjust to the incredible change, to go from believing I'm imprisoned by needs forever to realize I don't have any needs. It's just this massive shift. So, easy to know if you're on the path is, can you sit quietly? Can you sit quietly? Non-argumentatively, not coming on to anyone in any way. You're just sitting in the mood of huge breakthroughs are going to happen, and I'm going to quietly be able to handle that in this poised, quiet poise. That's where it's really at. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. Living as the light, we have no needs. Now, the fact is, we're already living as the light, except we're trying not to. We think that it's a different light. We're living with the light of matter. We think the electromagnetism is a different light than light. No, it's just light in a super condensed, frozen condition, actually. It's still the light. So we are still living as the light. And so we don't actually have any needs, but we're pretending that we do. Pretending at a very deep level. Don't just stop eating as a willful thing. No. The light will take care of whatever continuity issues we have with needs. We may still for a while feel that we have some needs, but fundamentally the entire situation is shifting over to abiding with the light, living as the light. I have no needs. Very important. So we have the testimony of several great beings that appeared in this world that we have no needs, actually. We don't. And you wonder, how in the world is that possible? Because we are the light. The light is not needy. But we're playing this game of believing that we have needs, because we say the light is a different light. This is a needy light. Electromagnetism is separate from light. That's what we think. We think we dwell in a separate realm of electromagnetism. Electromagnetism is the light. It's just actually in a super frozen condition. And we have Jesus to thank for this information, actually. It information is contained in Journey Beyond Words, the words of Jesus, transcribed by Dr. Brent Haskell. And this is very helpful information. Then we have Sri Anandamayi Ma in the world here, actually, in the past, recent past, saying she has no needs. She says, actually, she says the body doesn't have any needs, actually. You're just insisting upon this, that the body has needs. But she says, in reality, doesn't have any needs at all. And she didn't need to sleep. She didn't need to eat. You know, I guess she needed to breathe. I don't know if she even needed to breathe. No one asked her that, maybe. Maybe didn't even need to breathe. But she said, no, not really. I only do these things so that to keep you calm, so because you think that the body has needs. If I didn't eat at all, you'd freak out. But she says, no, I don't need to eat. And what about sleeping? You seem to sleep? No, I said, just I lie down so you think I'm sleeping, but I'm completely wide awake in the light. The light has no need to sleep whatsoever, actually. None. Don't try that at home. Don't just try to force it. But I'm saying that we have witnesses to this fact. The body doesn't really have any needs. Light doesn't have any needs. The body is light. Everything is light. There's nothing that isn't composed of 100% light, 100%, the one light. The one light composes all there is, without any exceptions. And this one light has no needs whatsoever. So we need to take the testimony and the evidence that we have and listen to the Holy Spirit, who's the advocate for truth, and start to say, hey, yeah, I'm aligning with that. I abide with the light. Yes, I do abide with the light. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. I have no needs. Insist upon it. Insist upon it. Insist upon it. It's either that or fall prey to the blueprints of those who are suffering from severe denial of their continuity problem. Severe denial. We accept we have a continuity problem, so we need to practice this stuff. They say, oh no, we don't have a continuity problem. The fear is just that we can't supply our needs enough. We gotta, you know, so that's what they think. The problem is, oh yes, we're very needy, but we've got to get better at supplying our needs. What we're saying is, hey, no, we don't. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. We're turning back towards truth, away from illusion, delusion, and we're evaporating the continuity problem as we do so. And this is the big game, actually. The big game is to set down this little game that we're playing. So, once again, I abide with the light. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. I have no needs. So we continue here, pushing the breakthroughs to the utmost. And give yourself time to let this sink in. That's very important. Okay, keep this one a short one. That's it.